Hey guys, welcome back. Today on The Untidy Artist, we're making a ballerina fairy doll. I have two daughters that absolutely love to dance, and so this little ballerina fairy doll is a doll I've been wanting to do a tutorial on for a long time. I'm really excited with how she turned out. Let's grab some supplies and get started. Now, the first thing you'll need is a fairy doll body. To learn how to do this, please click on my video in the upper right-hand corner. Click on the video and it will take you to a link and a tutorial where I go through step-by-step instructions on how to take a piece of floral wire, some thread, and a wooden bead and twist it into this cute little doll. Also, if you want to give her an updo hairstyle, please click on the link for my updo hairstyle where I teach you how to braid her hair and put it in this cute little twisty bun. And I will put both of those links below in the comments also. Next, you'll need some thread. I have this dark pink thread that I'll be using to put a little leotard on our fairy. And then I have this really pretty shiny pink, the light ballerina pink that we'll be making her point shoes out of. Then you'll need some cute embellishments. I have this little sequin flower that I wanted to put in her hair to just kind of decorate her. And then also I have some iridescent glitter, and I will be putting the iridescent glitter on the top of her tutu. And these are both totally optional, just whatever you have that you want to decorate your little ballerina fairy with, grab that. The next thing you'll need is some flowers for her tutu. Now I'll be using Gerbera daisies. I like how these stick out just like a ballerina tutu, and I'm actually using two of the flowers, and I'll only be using a few of the petals on each flower to create her tutu. Then you'll need some sharp scissors, and my glue gun set on low, of course, because it's much easier to work with the glue if it's set on low. The first step is to grab your doll, and you're going to dress her with whatever color you've chosen for her clothing. And to learn how to do this, refer back to my basic fairy doll tutorial. You can do that by clicking on the link on the video up in the right-hand corner there. And once you've created her little leotard, you want to grab the pink that you're using for the ballet shoes. Now, I actually decided to use the darker pink for this tutorial because I figured it would be easier for you to see what I was doing, but with most of my little ballerina fairies, I will use the lighter shiny pink. So what you're going to do is put a dab of glue at the very end of her foot, and you're going to take your thread up and over the glue and then start to wrap it around the end of her foot. So you're wrapping it around the piece that you're holding down, and you're going to put it over the tip of the foot so it covers all of her foot. And then once you've wound it around a few times, I'm going to cut off that excess piece. And you'll just wind it up a little ways. We're creating point shoes. So once you get up about an eighth of an inch, eighth to a fourth of an inch, depending on how big you want her shoes to be, you're going to put a little dab of glue to hold the shoes in place. So this is the main part of her ballet shoe. And then you're going to wrap the thread around to create the laces. So to do this, you're going to take the thread across the front, around the back once, and then over the front to create an X across the first part that you took around. So I'm taking up, around once, and then back down, creating an X. And then I wrap it back down to the very tip of her foot and add some more glue, and you have a point shoe. Work slowly as you get to the end of her shoe to kind of evenly just wrap that around. And once you're finished wrapping her shoe, go ahead and trim off the excess thread, and then you'll do the exact same thing for her other point shoe. And you can always use your glue gun to kind of hold the tip of the glue gun against any glue that needs to be melted more or that's showing too much. here's your cute little point shoe. And you can see I'm just using the tip of the glue gun to kind of melt some of the excess glue that was on her shoe. A hairdryer also works really well to melt extra glue off. And so here she's got her two point shoes. And now I'm going to make her skirt. So I'm going to pull both of the Gerbera daisies apart. And I'm going to be using the smallest sections of both of the flowers. So I'm going to set the bigger petals aside for another project. I felt that they were a little bit too wide for her tutu, so I'll just be using the smaller ones. Now normally I put the shortest layers of the skirt on the top, but with this we're going to put the shortest layers underneath and the bigger layers on the top because we want her skirt to be full and stick out like a tutu. And then I'm going to cut an X into each one. So right in the center, I'm going to cut an X, allowing us to slide that skirt up and around our fairy. And then you just slide them on, and you can see by putting that smallest layer underneath, it's going to help the tutu stick out and look like a tutu. And then grab your glue gun and put small dabs of glue between the layers, holding the skirt together. And work slowly and do it in the front and kind of pinch it together as you go to hold the skirt together. And make sure that the skirt is layered, that the flowers lay on top of each other the way that you want them. You don't want them laying on top of each other exactly. You want them to overlap a little bit to create a full skirt. And then do the same thing in the back. And you can see also that by using two flowers, we're getting a lot of the smaller petals to give her a fuller skirt. I tried it with just one and it didn't work out nearly as cute. And ta-da, we have a cute little ballerina. Now I'm going to grab the little sequin flower that I have for her hair. And it's iridescent, so it catches the light really pretty. And once again, to learn how to do the updo hairstyle, just refer back to my video where I go through step-by-step instructions on how to do this. And then the last step, I'm going to grab my iridescent glitter and I'm going to put some glue right on the top of her skirt. So I grabbed a piece of paper so I can sprinkle my glitter over it. And I start right at her waist and I'm just going to kind of do some little zigzags out towards the end of her skirt, just right around her waist. And then I'm going to do that on the front, sprinkle the glitter on, tap off the excess, and then I'm going to do the same on the back. So you can see I'm just taking little lines down with the glue gun, with the glue. We just want a little bit of sparkle here. So we don't want the glue to be really thick, we just want it thin. And then tap off the excess, and I pour the rest of my glitter back for another project. And that's it, guys. You're all set. You have a darling ballerina fairy doll. I think it would be a lot of fun to do different ballerina fairies for different ballets, like the Nutcracker or Swan Lake. And I just had a lot of fun making these. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already subscribed, please do. Please check out some of my other tutorials. I've done a lot of really fun different fairy dolls as well as some other craft projects. And you can also go to my website, untidyartist.com. And thanks, guys. We'll see you next time.